Hi and welcome! In this episode we will look at an excellent delay called color copy from Yuhi. In past episodes I've talked about the importance of having reverbs and delays that really helps to drive and make your sound organic in this digital environment that we work in these days. So, without further ado, my name's Mattias, let's take the tour! Yeah, so this is a color copy from Yuhi. To begin with, this plugin began as a part of the Repro synthesizer, but since the quality was so great, they broke it out and made a separate plugin for it. And that's very good, because now we can use this delay in other synths too. So color copy is a kind of analog delay, which is, I think they call it bucket brigade delay. And why I use color copy in many of my sounds is because it has a little life of its own. And if we look at this electric piano kind of sound that I have here, we can see how the different modes of the delay sounds. Let's first take the first color here called Resso. You will hear it has a resonating peak. And if we go further to Sparkle, it has a quite smooth sound. Then we go to Fuzz. This is actually the favorite of mine, but it all depends on what kind of sounds that you feed into the delay. Let's go to Snap. And to the Dusk mode. Another cool feature of the color copy is that you have this ducking function. And what the ducking does is basically it reduces the delay signal while you have incoming signal. So as soon as the incoming signal is gone, it will bring back the delay. And you have various ways of changing this threshold to get to tune in the exact amount of ducking that you want. Then we have some saturation controls. And this is the actual modulation part of the delay, which I really like because it really gives a stereo depth and stereo spread to your sound. So if we drag this all the way down, so we have zero depth. We almost have a mono signal, and then if we drag this depth up, it will start to detune the delays more and more. And you have different modes here to select from, so I like this tape position. Which really gives some smooth movement into your sound. And then you have the delay rate. And here you can smoothly change the rate of delay while the delays are playing. And that gives a very organic feel to your sound. So let's make it to 1 over 8 dots, and then we drag this down. So you can really make some cool effects with this. Maybe this could be used for transitions and many other cases too. The region is actually the feedback, so if we increase this, we will get an infinite amount of delays almost. We can also change the feedback modes to crossfeed. Initially, the delay taps are set to the same time, but you can change this during playback to set it maybe to 50%. maybe a little bit more modulation depth there. But a little bit of depth goes a long way to make your sound stereo. And in the beginning you saw me using this freeze function. So I played a little phrase and now it will take that delay and freeze it and replay it. Which is a very cool feature. And while you have the sound freezed, you can also change this depth and the rate and region and these left and right buttons. So let's run a little phrase again. Yeah, so you can really create some evocative soundscape with this delay. And as I said, this is what I really like about the great effect, that you can modulate and that it has a little life of its own. And that can help your sound design a lot. So I've created a little cue here using Zebra 2 synth in combination with the color copy. So let's take a little listen and then we will break it down and look at the presets. Okay, so that's the cue, and we have a lot of different presets going on in this one. Here we have first a pad that's created with Zebra 2. Zebra is still in my arsenal as a favorite synth because it has so great and warm sound, and it's easy and quick to come up with sounds. And for this sound I was using two oscillators. This is the generator section, or your oscillators. And then you have your mix page in the middle here. And to the right is the modulation and envelopes, LFOs, etc. And down here you can zoom in on your different oscillators and dive in and make more changes to them. You also have various modes for creating your waveform, like SpectroBlend. Here you can actually draw where you want your fundamental and harmonics in the spectrum. And then you have, if you go to global here, you have your output section with some output effects and the send effects. And for this one I was only using the compressor. And we have two oscillators, a sawtooth and another sawtooth. And both of these are set to stacking dual mode, which means we have two oscillators for each oscillator generator. Then we have a filter and it's set to low pass excite. And within Zebra you have all these filters, which are really great and very analog sounding too. You have something called the LPA Vintage 2, which is one of my favorites. This filter cutoff was modulated by the envelope number 2 here, and you have a quick attack and a quite short decay. So this is what it sounds like. And I also have the arpeggiator activated. They updated this arpeggio section so it's easier to control your arpeggiation and also add modulation if you want. Here you can see. And we can have this arp step modulating different parameters within the synth. And then you have these msegs. I wish Bitwig would include msegs in the DAW, but it's not there yet, but hopefully. And then we have a matrix for sending modulation between parameters and a target. So you can just drag here and set, maybe I want the drive to be modulated by LFO1, and then you just drag the amount of the source to be modulating this drive. And so we have this arpeggio going, and it goes into color copy, which has some modulation to the delays, which makes it spread in more in the stereo field. I also offset the left and right delays slightly. And with some EQ, I got rid of a little bit of lows. Then we have another pad, which is this sweeping kind of pad. And then for the chorus, we have super sauce. Not sauce, but super sawtooth. So let's take a look at that sound. We have the Zebra 2. And in this super saw sound, we have oscillator 1, which is set to quad. And that means we have four voices, and they are slightly detuned. And in oscillator 2, we all have 11 voices, and they are also slightly detuned. And I also activated the pulse width modulation and set the LFO1 generator, which is this generator, to modulate the phase. And then a little bit of noise. And Zebra is really good for learning synthesis, because if you find a preset that you really like, you can just deactivate certain devices by double-clicking at them. And you can really break it down and see how this sound was constructed. So I actually learned a lot about synthesis from using Zebra. So it's a great tip for new synth gurus. And then we have a few leads. And this is created with this kind of waveform for the first oscillator section. And then the second oscillator is a high-pitched with 11 voices and even more detuned. So together they make this nice creamy sound. And on the first one I also have the shaper, which is a really great device to add a grit to your sound. And I often use this wedge type within the shaper to make it really gritty. And then in the global section, you set your mode to legato to make this a monophonic sound, legato sound, and activate some glide so that the notes will glide into each other. So there we have one of the leads, and then it's dubbed with another lead. Let's take a look at that sound. The oscillator 1 is a square, and the oscillator 2 is also a square, but it's detuned an octave above. So you have two squares going on there. And the first single and this higher oscillator is quad, so it's four voices. And I also have the mod mapper, which is basically, this will increase. You can see that the mode is set to increment. So for each time you press a note, it will go one step further in this sequence. So you get different results for each key press. And here is a more creamy lead. It has a lot more filter, deformant filter for this one. I'm using the GeoBlend waveform for this one, and I've created this weird waveform that I kind of liked. And then set it to dual mode and added this this shape device again to make some more grit into the sound. And this is also set to glide mode with the legato, so you get that smooth transition. Okay, so let's take a look at this lead again. It's using the color copy delay again, and I've set the depth of the modulation quite high, so you have a lot of stereo movement and the pitch is really drifting on the sound, which make it sound a lot more alive and nice and smooth and creamy. Yeah, so I highly recommend that you check out color copy to breathe some life into your digital sounds. It has a really great analog feel, and that modulation will really breathe life into your sterile digital sounds. There's a link in the description here to go and check it out. Okay, so how do you use delays and reverbs in your productions? Do you use more of delays or do you use more of reverbs? Please subscribe, like if you like, leave a comment in the comment section if you have any questions on this video, color copy or Zebra. Thanks for watching today. My name is Mattias and catch you in the next video. Bye bye.